What's up, everybody? It is Tuesday, March 15th, 2022 AD, Anno Domini, 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Daylight Time. Have to get used to saying daylight time again, right when I just started getting used to saying standard time. And this is the Hake Report. I am James Hake. I have some calls to get to. I have some interesting, or to me it's interesting. I don't know if it's going to be interesting to you, but it's dumb feminist stuff. You know, I like to bash the women. I'm mockingly referencing a call that I got from my friend and yours, who complained that I was always bashing women and catering to the far right and stuff like that. But anyway, I'm going to talk about some feminist homosexual movie. I don't know what it is, but talking about some drama about around it, right? And also, Johns Hopkins University is pushing the gay agenda. That is the transgender agenda. And Colorado is pushing abortion. And it's a big mess. By the way, I heard that China is experiencing a spike in the China virus infections, and so they're locking down all over again. Is that going to come to America? I'm just asking the question. Maybe I shouldn't even ask, right? Coming back to America? I don't know. All that and your calls. But anyway, guys, let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la.
Hey, guys!
Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la. La, la.
So, how are you guys doing? I am fine. I wanted to, by the way, it's Tuesday. Women's Forum this Thursday, ladies. Bond Women's Forum. I always pump it up because I really like the men's forums, and I assume that the women's forums are excellent too. Kind of good reminders, get you back on track or stay on track or, you know, let us not give up meeting together as some are in the habit of doing. That's a reference from the Bible. So it's a fact, you know, not to gossip, but to fellowship if you don't barf at that word. Or, sorry, kids, spit at that word. Because some people are turned off by Christianese-type words like fellowship. But anyway, I really like the men's forums. They're excellent. You learn from one another, and it's cool. Anyway, let me... You know what? I wanted to get to this gay agenda thing, but I got to calls kind of late last time. And so let me get to calls kind of early this time. How about that? What do you think? Let me first get to Social Pariah, Denver, Colorado. He is a nice young man. Social Pariah, how are you doing? Are you there? Social Pariah.
Can we?
Yes, now I can hear you.
Okay.
You had me on mute or something?
No, I had it on my tether to my radio, so I just picked it up.
Oh, I see.
I was just calling a reference, you know, when you were on the hippie-dippie round table.
Yeah,
you know,
I was
kind of scoffed.
Remind me which hippie-dippie round table, because it feels like so long ago, which it was only probably a week and a half ago or two.
Well, all of them.
Oh, okay.
But particularly the ones you were on the most recent, because they scoffed at you when you called capitalism, commie capitalism.
Oh, right.
Which, which is not far off because they use communist tactics, you know, as far as like accuse your enemy of what you're doing.
Yep.
A whole bunch of stuff like that.
Yeah.
But I started listening to Glenn Beck's The Great Reset.
Uh-huh.
And it appears nobody really knows what to call this movie, what we're seeing now, because we've never seen it before.
Okay. But we know that it's evil.
Yeah. Yeah, that for sure. I mean, it's undermining our liberty.
True.
And once they have that, I mean, people are like, it's not that important. You know, that these are minor things. But whenever your liberty's gone, then they decide what. You know, I mean, it's something that, you know, our forefathers, it might have been a long time ago, but human nature has never changed.
Yeah.
Know?
Yeah, that's
they,
true.
They knew back then.
Although you say we haven't seen them do what they're doing today, there's nothing new under the sun.
No, absolutely not. I mean, it's a few elites that want to control the, you know, they want the public to be dependent on, you know, the government.
Right.
And to like I said on Jussie and on your show too, that whenever nothing's free, whenever you give up something, you know, whenever you get something, you're giving up something.
Yeah, for sure.
And yeah, it's not exactly communism what we're seeing now, because they don't want the means of production in the hands of the workers. They want to put it in the lead. Okay.
You're breaking up a little bit there, but I think I'm catching your drift. They want control. The so-called the people who consider themselves elites, although Trump says we're the elite, you're the elite, which I like.
It really doesn't matter. What I was really going to my point was, it really doesn't matter what you call it. It's wrong.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's good versus evil, because it is so many of these things that we name it. We name it anti-white. We name it anti-Christian. Yeah, we call it crony capitalism. I call it commie capitalism. People call it socialism. Although
technocracy.
Yeah, right. All kinds of stuff, but it's evil, and you call out evil.
And those guys know what you're talking about.
Yeah,
but, I mean, you know, that's one of the things, you know, that leftists do is, I mean, if they want to pigeonhole you, so they just keep, you know, what is the definition of that? You know, like, does it really matter?
Right. I know. They're like, well, actually, this. Okay, so I was last on Hippy Dippy Roundtable Friday, March 4th. And should the U.S. give Ukraine aid? And how was Biden's State of the Union speech? And we talked about how they're kissing up to women and having women working. You know, and we kind of took over. I don't know. My comments kind of sidetracked the whole conversation, interestingly. But it was a fun discussion. A couple of Australians there. A woman who kind of shut down because she was so upset at my comments, I guess. And that made her the least annoying woman whom I've ever debated in my life. She was like the least annoying, even though she's one of the more liberal.
Well, she was into NATO the United Nations.
Right.
And those are both, you know, part of like world, you know, they want like a central governing body.
Yeah, very true.
Should not be supporting the UN.
She was Australian. And you're right. NATO, I learned that NATO, I just saw a couple of hints, indications. Maybe it was on Anchor Baby's new show. It might have been on Anchor Baby's new show on Friday, because I caught it just the most recent one, just from this past Friday, which would have been, what, the 11th or something? And I think he was the one who showed how NATO is pushing the gay agenda, the LGBTIQ stuff. In every member country has to allow, you know, the so-called LGBTIQ plus rights. So that's not good. And feminism and all that stuff. It's no wonder. And so they're pushing that to be on Ukraine and all that stuff. They're not merely a defensive alliance. They are an offensive. That's offensive.
That's one of the things he was talking about in the book also is, well, they've tried to, everything they do is to try to divide to keep people off of the real issues.
Yeah.
Like racism.
Yep.
Globalism, COVID.
Children.
Anything you can keep.
Children against parents, parents against children. They're doing that in the schools and on social media and everything else, in laws. That's so true. They, you know, in, you know, I'm producer, meaning like I put out online content for Church with Jesse Lee Peterson, and there's an archive service coming up tomorrow evening, hopefully. And Jesse talks about that in this 2013 service about how they are making it so children can like report their parents for so-called child abuse. And you, he see it in Florida. And in Texas, how they're trying to make the children turn transgender, and they're trying to push the gay agenda and abortion on kids without parental consent or knowledge, vaccinate the kids, teach the kids that they're smarter than the parents, in that the kids believe in climate change, but I don't know if there are any more boomer parents of young kids. But the parents don't know anything about climate change because they weren't brainwashed in it the way that the kids were. All that division to hide from the fact that the government is pushing evil. What a mess, huh?
Yeah, that's one of the things about Glenn Beck's book. He has, footnotes and stuff so that he suggests that you don't just get the Audible book, so that if you can debate someone on it, you have fact-based, you know, and he said, you know, that it's saying, you know, everybody, even the people, you know, on the far right, whenever they, you know, heard of what was going on at Davos and Agenda 21, and
yeah,
they're like, well, that's just, you know, that's too crazy to be true.
Nope, it's true.
But, yeah, it's true, and I mean, it's people got to wake up to it because it's real, you know?
Yeah. Yep. Interesting,
but,
man.
Anyways,
nice
to
hear from
you. I won't keep it too much long. Yeah, yeah. I'll talk to you later, Rick.
All right. Take care. Bye. Social pariah, guys. He's Gen X. I do have another appearance coming up on Modern Day Debate on Friday. And I don't think that I will be having the Hake Report on Friday, although I will be doing Hake News for the Jesse Lee Peterson Show. But I have to take care of something on Friday morning-ish, late morning. But I will be on Modern Day Debate, like I mentioned yesterday. Modern Day Debate this Friday, 6 p.m. Pacific, that's 9 Eastern, debating against a woman named Carissa about, or discussing, right, Lin Yenshin? is there a war on men? Of course there is. Of course there is. Let me quickly get to William in California. He was on the line yesterday as well. William, how are you doing, man?
Oh, good morning. How you doing, man?
Fine.
Good, good, good. Woke up to some rain. There's some rain out here in the valley.
Nice. The valley.
Yeah, that is nice. That is nice. I didn't have to. I'm glad those sprinklers didn't come on.
That's not the water. That's not the San Fernando Valley, is it? Or the
San Joaquin Valley.
Okay. Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. Yesterday, you had a very interesting conversation with a young man, one of your callers, Mike.
Yeah, Mike from Michigan.
Yeah, yeah. With all due respect to Mike, I just wanted to, you know, point out the fact that he started off with two very extreme conversations about the Bible and the turning of the pages in the scripture and what is a Christian and what is not a Christian.
Yeah.
I do not qualify to call anybody a Christian or if they're not or whatever. I don't.
Okay.
And my experience is that the person that is least to talk about who is and who isn't might be more godly than a person who likes to turn those pages. So I personally don't qualify to do that. But it went from that to the Black Lives Matter thing.
Right, and Trayvon Martin.
And you and I have had this conversation before about the difference between black people and African Americans. If you're an African American, you're more than likely going to support something like Black Lives Matter, because it's a fact that it was started by fat, black, lazy lesbians.
Yeah, and my point was that those fat, black, radical lesbians, they're not valuing even their own lives. They're getting into, they've only gotten fatter. They're into the LGBTQ thing and pushing that on other people. That's not life. That's death.
And it's not manly.
Right.
A black man that is hardworking, honorable, lots of integrity.
Yeah.
And lives correct. He will never support something like that. That doesn't make you a man. That makes you male.
Yeah, it's just victimhood. False victimhood.
Yes, it is.
Yep.
And the carnage that Black Lives Matter and Antifa has caused over the last 2 years, it's in the millions upon millions of dollars worth of damage.
And a lot of them themselves have committed suicide because they're miserable.
They have done nothing for the black community.
Right.
They will never go into South Central, Long Beach, East Oakland, West Oakland, Chicago, New York. He was
Baltimore.
Comparing a small trailer park.
Yeah, I let
crime.
That slide.
For you to pull up a city that most of the audience never heard of,
right,
and compare it with inner city problems.
Yeah.
Now, you never ask me this question. I guess you don't, because you know I know better. You know, if you say something bad about what's going on in the black community, which is like representing over 70% of the crime in the country, for only 12% of the population, those numbers are too exact. And the crime and problems that blacks have in the neighborhood and in the family, if you mention it and you respond with, what about whites? It does nothing but keep it. What it does is it keeps you from addressing it.
Yeah. And it's hiding the truth. There's no comparison between the white crime levels and the black crime levels at this point.
Right. Yep. Right. So, I mean, the response of what about the whites and pulling up a town we never heard of and comparing it with Detroit, Chicago, Los Angeles, Oakland, New York.
It's ignorance.
It's very.
Yeah.
Very. It's not manly. Why don't you just look at that? Because there's a difference right there. You have a lot of black callers that listen to you that know this, and they have this kind of common sense.
Yeah. Well, I wish Mike from Michigan well. I enjoy talking with him. But
I do, too.
I
do, too.
I was surprised by some of the things that he was saying.
To take a look at that, because if you mention what's happening in the white community, and, oh, by the way, yes, Trayvon Martin, yes, they did have a right to follow him.
Right.
It's called Neighborhood Watch.
Yep.
And we have four people here in my neighborhood that are Neighborhood Watch. Yes, they can follow you. If you're not supposed to be in there, usually a Neighborhood Watch is a community that's kind of like gated a little bit in private.
Yeah, right.
And
they'd been having
Trayvon
break-ins.
Martin.
They'd had break-ins
in
the area.
Look at what they did with Trayvon Martin and Michael Brown. They showed pictures of these guys when they got killed, or whenever they died. Let's just say not killed. When they died,
right?
They showed pictures of these young men when they were 9 years old.
I know.
That was Professor Crump, that attorney. He does this every case.
Yeah.
He shows you a picture of that deceased person at 9 years old and touch a nerve in the black community purposely.
Yeah, that guy does not care about black
and
people.
Trayvon Martin
he's evil.
Was 6'4". Benjamin. Like the same size as me. He's like 6'4", 190, 200. He was a good-sized young man. And yes, Zimmerman had a right to follow him.
5'11". 5'11". Trayvon was.
Was he 5'11"?
Yeah.
Good enough size. I thought he was
that's
like
plenty.
Over 6 feet. He was 5'11"?
Yeah, according to Google, which is evil. How tall was
difference.
A gentle giant? Yeah, I mean,
I'll take that.
George Zimmerman's short.
5'11", 6'4", that's a big difference. But
yeah.
5'11", he's still a pretty good-sized kid.
Right.
And he was not a little boy. I heard this. Heard Mike say, you can't follow and do that and kill that boy like that. That was not the case.
Michael Brown was 6'4", 292.
That was the one.
Yeah, 292
pounds.
That was
the one that was pretty big.
Yeah.
And Darren Lewis was, what, really small.
Yeah, Darren Wilson was not that tall.
And he says, this is America. You can't follow people like that. First of all, they don't have a black neighborhood in this country that people would want to live in that have a neighborhood watch. You
yeah.
can't name one. So, you know,
yep.
Black Lives Matter is nothing but a big bag of breast milk.
Gross, man.
That, yeah, it is gross. And
gone
it's
sour.
True.
Gone sour,
it's
though.
Just like a bunch of mommy boys and not they're males, but not men.
Yeah.
And a real man would not follow something like Black Lives Matter or even say that that was a boy. It's not a boy.
Yeah, I know. That little boy.
That little boy.
Oh, man. He said, what are we in, 2012? Like, all the information has been out for 8 years.
If he's able to...
10 years.
If he's able to knock you to the ground, believe me, he's not a little boy.
Right. Yeah. I appreciate
not
it, William.
Boy.
It's good to hear from you, man.
You too.
All right, take care.
Take care.
Bye. Some super chats, guys. In fact, I am remiss in not reading the super chats from yesterday. There were several that came in yesterday. And, they were addressing, I got caught up with my call from Mike from Michigan at the tail end of yesterday's show, because I enjoyed talking with these blacks so much. Mike from Michigan, for example. Hydro says, with a super chat yesterday, on streamlabs.com/TheHake Report, Hake, between 1 to 10, what do you think Mike's IQ is? Oh, man, that's cold. Ask your caller if having a high IQ matters. Because he said he was expressing his support for the phrase Black Lives Matter, which is a mess. Uncle Ted 88 over there on Odyssey, odyssee.com/@TheHakeReport. Uncle Ted 88 says, ask him what pi means, P-I, because yesterday was Pi Day, according to Based America First. Not baked. Sorry, Based America First. I'm lumping you in with Baked Alaska, and that's a mess. But I like Baked Alaska, but totally different from Based America First. Yeah, ask him what pi means. 3.14. Yesterday was 3.14, March 14th. And so I got pizza on Based America First's super chat. Very nice. But I didn't eat it yet because I had pizza kind of recently. So, but I will. I appreciate that. Maybe the end of the month I will get that as a treat. John WX... 25 on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. That scumbag Mallorca, Alejandro Mayorkas, who's the so-called secretary of the Department of Homeland so-called Security, I think, under sleepy Joe Biden, will add any negative speech. We'll add you to the extremists list. Watch and listen. Anything for the deviants. Yes, John WX 25. I didn't completely understand the wording. May have gotten garbled there. But yes, that's something that Based America First mentioned, was that Alejandro Mayorkas said, if you believe the election was stolen, which of course, guys, it wasn't. I did like a winky face. It was not stolen. Don't be an extremist. But if you think so, then you're going to go on the extremist list, according to Alejandro Mayorkas. What a mess, huh? They're just weeding out everybody who's says something out of line, out of the official narrative. Give me a break. They're doing that to Christians, whites, people who love the country, such as patriots. It's a shame. Anybody who does not get the vax is getting kicked out of the military and the doctor's world. So get in line or get out of society is the message. Wow. Lin Yen Chin with the Streamlabs super chat stated yesterday, and I mentioned the word ethics, and I think I mentioned it in like positive light by accident, right? So Lin Yen Chin jumped on that. He said, men have morality. Women only have ethics. Ethics are emulation of morality. They are just algorithms of intellect posing as discernment of right versus wrong. Intellectuals have morality deactivated by turning their back to reality as anecdotal, unreliable. Don't trust your lying eyes. Don't trust the God-given sense within. No. John WX25, thank you, Lin Yenjin. John WX25 says, libs push interracial relationships. Very true, they do. Not something to push. Not something to push. Illegal aliens, and they push illegal aliens because they know they are committing genocide on the blacks, and they know blacks won't fight the evil of abortion. Yeah, I suppose that's true, John WX25. Thank you, guys. Your girlfriend with a super chat says, so nice. What's up, your girlfriend? Nice to hear from you. Appreciate the support, as always. Lorena H with a super chat says, hi, Hake. What are your thoughts on PragerU? That's short for Prager University, right? PragerU. It's an online sensation. PragerU. It's everywhere. And that's named after Dennis Prager, a conservative guy, fairly conservative, right? He's Jewish. He loves Jesse Lee Peterson, by the way. He's written the forewords to multiple of Jesse Lee Peterson's books. Dennis Prager. Tall. He's tall, too. Nice. nice guy. And oftentimes quite logical. Sometimes not so much. For example, I heard him one time back in like 2015, 2016. He, and this is not PragerU specific, this is Dennis Prager himself. He was like, anybody but Trump. I'm for any Republican but Trump. You know, when there was like 17 different Republican people running for president. I was like, what? I was like, Trump or no one else. So I think it might be because he's like an intellectual and not a Christian, right? Although he is a nice guy. But I think that he has some blind spots. Anyway, I think he came around to liking Trump enough. But anyway, he said, I recently saw a video. I mean, not he. Lorena H. says, what are your thoughts on PragerU? I recently saw a video they made, PragerU made, on the Civil War, saying it was caused because of slavery. Thanks. Well, I haven't watched much PragerU. I did watch one in which Dennis Prager covered why Nazism is so hated while communism is basically, like, trendy. And he made some good points there. One being that intellectuals are in the academic world and in the media, and they're a bunch of liberals, by the way, and they go based on feelings and what's and thoughts and ideas rather than action and reality and results. So communism is based on, oh, equality. Sounds nice, huh? So if it sounds nice, but it kills 100 million people or whatever, that's fine. But since Nazism sounds racist, it sounds like it's racist, then they don't like it, even though Nazism only allegedly killed 10 million or whatever. Communism, 100 million. More than 10 times more, or 60 million, who knows how many, right? 6 to 10 times more than Nazism. And it's much more widespread and insidious. And by the way, they are communists themselves. So I liked that video, but I have not seen the Civil War one. I am sure that there is some, I know that slavery had something to do with it, right? Otherwise, he wouldn't have done the Emancipation Proclamation, right? But it was about much more than just slavery. But I haven't watched it, so I can't really comment on it. But I do, I like them. Some people really don't trust them. In fact, some of, like, the Groypers are like, PragerU, and they just roll their eyes hard at it. They link them together with the TPUSA types, which TPUSA promotes the gay agenda and feminism and props up blacks and diversity and mass immigration, although they've kind of flip-flopped on that. So just basically a bunch of rhinos, you know? And so some people lump them all together. I couldn't tell you. I don't pay too much attention to them. I only read CNN and The Skim. So, but I do, nonetheless, I do appreciate Dennis Prager for what he is. And that's cool. Very nice. Thank you, Lorena H. Let me double check on the super chats on Odyssey. Thank you, guys. I appreciate that. Anyway, I have to finally get into some of the topics that I planned for today. We are past halfway into the hour. Speaking of propping up the gay agenda, Johns Hopkins pushing the LGBTIQ thing. And I mentioned Johns Hopkins University because they are the ones giving us all of these chinavirus numbers, right? The deaths, the infections, they have this database. And I think that that guy who's black and nice and fairly conservative, Dr. Ben Carson, who was Secretary of HUD, Housing and Urban Development, which there should be no housing and urban development, in my opinion, at the federal level. But if somebody's going to run it, it better be Ben Carson, not some of these people who are redistribution of ghetto. But I think that he worked at Johns Hopkins University in the past. Dr. Ben Carson, the man who separated conjoined twins who were conjoined at the head. They were like Siamese twins, you know, when they're stuck together, their two bodies are stuck together. And he separated them at the head. He was a brain surgeon. I guess he's not still a brain surgeon, but he's a fairly honorable man, right? Or male? Ben Carson? Anyway, Johns Hopkins University, I have some screenshots from their website. They support the transgender agenda. Transgender so-called health. What? And they're known for COVID-19 updates. And what does one have to do with the other? They're completely separate departments, but still. Something's fishy about a university and a university known for its health and medical field, such as Johns Hopkins, that supports the transgender agenda. I guess that's what they have to do to remain in the establishment, right? Center for Transgender Health is what they have on their website. Two whole pages dedicated to it. I'm reading this from their website. The Johns Hopkins Center for Transgender Health. I'm shaking my head. Offers comprehensive evidence-based and affirming care. Affirming is a buzzword, right? Gender affirming. I told you about that yesterday. Of course, many of you already knew that. For transgender youth and adults, meaning children and adults, that is in line with the standards of care set by the, listen to this, World Professional Association. You can go ahead and show these screenshots, just kind of go through in the Johns Hopkins transgender so-called healthcare. Because I was looking at this when I was doing the Hake News, and the pictures that they have are pretty garish, by the way, photographs. We offer evidence-based affirming care. Look at the, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Sorry, kids, cover your eyes. Adults, cover your eyes and ears. Well, not ears. Gender-affirming care is the line. The World Professional Association for Transgender Health, which is WPATH, World Professional Association for So-Called Transgender Health, is where they get their information. And the T in WPATH, W-P-A-T-H, WPATH, is all baby blue, like a transgender blue. Creating an environment in which our patients and their families feel safe and confident in the care they receive is central to the mission of Johns Hopkins Medicine. And it has some... Look at... Can you do me a favor, which is not doing the viewers a favor, but zoom in on some of these photographs. I can't even believe that... okay. So, in the... Okay, these two... I don't know what these people are. It's disconcerting. It's very disconcerting. We're looking at a black person, and I don't know, maybe a lady who's playing man. I can't tell. I think so. And wearing big glasses and all hip and weird. Shaved side of the head. And then another black purportedly woman. And it shows, like, the front breasts, right? But it makes the way that it says surgical services underneath this photograph of this black woman, pretty lady, but I don't know if it's actually a lady, with dyed red hair. I guess she's put... Is she putting makeup on? I don't know who that is, what that is. But anyway, it's called surgical services, so it makes me think, uh-oh, what are they doing? And then in the top, it has this person who looks like it might be a dude. And, but with a hairstyle like a woman and a skinny neck like a woman. And maybe lipstick like a woman. And maybe eyeshadow like a woman. But bags under his or her eyes like a depressed transgender. What a mess, huh? And there are other photographs that... We just showed you earlier about gender-affirming care, and I was aghast at this. Gender-affirming care. This is from Johns Hopkins University, the same place that's supplying us reliable data on the China virus, by the way. And it has this, I don't know, on the left, it has this guy who looks like a fat black guy. But that might be a girl, because a lot of times when they give them the hormones, these girls, these young ladies, grow beards. And look like dudes. So I can't tell. And in the middle, it's the person who looks like a black lady. But then when you look at the face is actually lipstick on a dude. And then on the right, it looks like a dude, but it also looks like a girl. What in the world? What a mess. And they have this Asian woman, by the way, whom I can't tell. Is this supposed to be a transgender too, or is it just an Asian woman who supports this surgery underneath that picture? There's a picture of this Fan Liang, who's the medical director for Johns Hopkins Center for Transgender Health. Is that a normal, and I use the term normal loosely, young doctor lady? Or is it a young doctor dude who's dressed like a lady? I don't know. It's so confusing. What a mess. So it's terrible. That's Johns Hopkins University for you. And there are other photographs, and some of them are obviously, what is that? When you just use, anyway, what a mess. Terrible. Standards of care. The World Professional Association for Transgender Health promotes the highest standards of healthcare for individuals through the articulation of the standards of care. And this is not healthcare. It's not. It's validating them in their wrong. So they feel better. And I had these debates on Modern Day Debate over in Dallas, Texas. Was it Dallas, I think? Public policy statements, a full listing of recent public policy statements from the World Professional. So they're just referencing this World Professional Association for Transgender Health. And then they have stock photography of doctors. Services and appointments. Oh, can you show this one? It's probably, I don't know, services and appointments. It has a three panel. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so this one on the left, I'm just, hopefully I'm describing it okay for the people who are listening only. On this left, it has this I don't know if it's a guy, but he's wearing, he's all emaciated and on a cane. And it says, we offer a complete spectrum, there's a buzzword, of gender-affirming services for adults. And it's this dude who's like, I don't know if he had surgery and now he's like, can barely walk right now because he's recovering or what? Or she or he or I don't know what. And it has that, in the middle, it has that guy who looks, who has the hairdo like a girl with a bun and bangs that I told you about before, same person and same so-called doctor, that young guy is a doctor. And then it has dykey-looking people on the right. What a mess, huh? Anyway. That's the website. So, anyway. I don't know if that did... I don't know. I hope that was edifying for you guys. Terrible. What shall I do next? Okay, before I get to calls, let me cover one more story, guys. Abortion in Colorado, okay? I told you in Hake News at the end of our, I think, two of the Jesse Lee Peterson show today that, oh no, it was the end of hour one. Killing the babies. CNN says the Colorado House of Representatives yesterday passed a bill called the Reproductive Health Equity Act, supporting so-called abortion rights. No such thing, right? The legislation states, every individual, this is a quote, every individual has a fundamental right to use or refuse contraception, and every pregnant individual, kissing up to the transgenders and non-binaries, right? Because it used to be pregnant woman or pregnant girl, because sometimes girls get pregnant too before they become women. Has a, every pregnant individual has a fundamental right to continue the pregnancy and give birth, or to have an abortion. That's a quote from the Democrat sponsor of the bill, or the bill's copy, writing. The Democrat sponsor of the bill is this woman named Meg Froelich. Oh, let me drag these into the folder. Ooh, okay. Replace, okay. I put in two more pictures of this thing. So, Colorado, this is a CNN headline, abortion rights bill, no such thing, passes in Colorado House. And they're all excited about it. The Democrat sponsor of the bill is this woman named, and I use the term loosely, Meg Froelich, F-R-O-E-L-I-C-H. She hailed it as a big win for protecting access to abortion and reproductive health care. As you may know, the other states have been restricting abortions. Florida, West Virginia, Arizona, they have what they call 15-week abortion bans. I think Texas or Florida, which one, has the heartbeat bill, which is supposedly 6 weeks. And heartbeat really means cardiac activity, right? They detect cardiac activity because it's not a fully formed heart. It's not exactly a beat. It's just movement or whatever. But whatever. Doesn't matter. I mean, it should be at conception, honestly. In Idaho, the state legislature gave final approval yesterday to a bill that would ban abortion after 6 weeks and allow the father, sibling, grandparent, grandfather, grandmother, aunt or uncle of the fetus, the CNN says, fetus, to bring legal action against medical professional, the medical professional who performed the abortion. They should also sue the woman who killed the baby, who was a party to it. Sometimes I hear the man pressures the woman to have an abortion. You've had guests on the Jesse Lee Peterson show say, oh, you know what, I asked her to have an abortion. Because this guy would sleep around, some of these people would sleep around, get a woman pregnant. And the woman would say, I'm pregnant. And the man says, get an abortion. So sometimes it's pressure, but oftentimes the man doesn't want the woman to kill the baby, his baby, but she does it anyway. And the man has no so-called reproductive rights. So much for your reproductive health equity, right? Give me a break. So phony. Reproductive health. It's not health. Killing the baby? Please. So let me show you a clip of this woman named Meg Froelich, who's arguing in favor of this bill, And she's appealing to the people who are opposed to the bill, saying, if you don't support this, then you have to support other women's rights so we don't have this problem in the first place. Listen to this woman.
Over and over again, we heard how important it is, how important it was, and how important it shall be that these decisions be made by the pregnant person and their medical provider. If they so choose to include their rabbi, their pastor, or their family, that is up to them. I ask the people who are opposed to this legislation to join with me in making a world where reproductive health care decisions are not economically motivated, where we dismantle systemic racism, a world where women receive equal wages, where children do not go hungry, where housing is a right, mental health is prioritized, contraceptives are readily available, domestic violence is not tolerated, and GLBTQ folks are respected. Trust Coloradans, trust women, preserve our privacy, preserve our choices, and pass the Reproductive Health Equity Act.
What a psycho woman. Look at her. Yikes. Get that thing off stage. Vote her out. What's wrong with Colorado? Colorado used to be fairly conservative. I'm shaking my head. So did Arizona. So did California. Systematic. Oh, get rid of systemic racism. Housing is all right. DV, domestic violence is not tolerated. Trust women. No. You just showed me why I shouldn't trust women. Shameful. She seems like she's like a high school coach. You know what I mean? Like an athletic coach. One of those sort of, is it bad to say dykey? Like, you know, not morally straight ladies. Watch James say she was pretty. You know, if she slimmed down, she might be. Oh, I have a photograph of her because she, okay, I put it in the folder. She tweeted for International Women's Day, you know, it was March 8th. By the way, it's Women's History Month. What a mess. Terrible. And by the way, why did she say rabbi first before pastor? What kind of country are we living in? And whatever else. Look at this woman. She tweeted Happy International Is my voice mocking her more annoying than her voice, her normal voice, supposedly normal? Anyway, she tweeted, Happy International Women's Day on March 8th. So lucky to celebrate with these amazing ladies. And I'm like, where is she? Where is she? Where is she? And I'm like, oh, there she is. So I have a zoomed in picture. There she is right in the middle. Yikes. She seems nice. But look at this. Some of these ladies are kind of haggard. And, you know, they don't belong in these positions of power. It's stressful. It's not good for you. But she has this funny smile. Almost charming. But she's kind of fat. And she has like this. For the people, the audience who's listening and not seeing the video, she's doing one of those smiles where you see her lower teeth too. And it's just like a strange smile. What a mess. Trust women. No. That's horrific. Not good. Beautiful area. Is that in the Colorado House or something like that? Terrible. Terrible. So I had to share that with you. I wanted to get to the more stories. Oh, man. My gosh. Bull dagger runs off the tongue, though. Is that a bad thing to say, too? Not good. Not good at all. Couple of super chats before because I don't like to miss them. Asmador over there. Asmador. A-Z-Z. M-A-D-O-R. Guys, some people don't know what I'm saying. States on Odyssey with a super chat. Ovid and trans. And I think it means COVID and trans. Equals money, money, money. Oh, is that why? Yeah. Ill-gotten gain. Shame on Johns Hopkins University. They're getting their notoriety off the China virus numbers. And yeah, maybe some of them are somewhat accurate, but I don't know. And the transgender agenda, money, money, money. Indeed. COVID meaning the China virus. Yeah, that's true. John WX25 on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. Bottom line, where's Lebozo? Obama. I mean, I think he means Lebozo is in LeBron James, the tennis player. Not as good, though, as that one guy who says no vax, Djokovic. Is he still no vax? I heard that he got shut out of another tournament here in America over his not getting a China virus communist vaccine. But I thought that he changed his mind and started to try to get the vax, but I don't know if he did. No vax, Djokovic. But anyway, bottom line, where's Lebozo, Obama, and Oatmeal Winfrey living? Hint, not with the Blats. I guarantee Mike hits it big. He ain't living in the hood. Oh, you're talking about Mike from Michigan? John WX25 is going after Mike from Michigan, my caller at the end of the show yesterday. Your girlfriend says, states with the super chat. Hasmador says, that's a man, referring to the deep-voiced dykey lady, and I use the term lady loosely, who pushed the abortion agenda in Colorado. Your girlfriend with a super chat on Odyssey, odyssee.com/@TheHakeReport. I have a strong distaste for Jen Psaki. It's quite understandable. She dyes her hair like a weird, bright, reddish thing. And she has a smart mouth, as in she's not smart, but her mouth is a smart mouth. You know what I mean? You know. And your girlfriend says, Jen Psaki, and she looks like a man. That's what your girlfriend says. Not being disrespectful, though, right? Be careful how you describe that thing. Yeah. And she's a communist. She's evil. She's an Obama holdover. And now she's Sleepy Joe's press secretary. Awful. Not good. We're at 5 minutes till. Let me get to Richard in North Carolina. He's on the line. Richard in North Carolina, how are you doing?
What's up? So, you know, when I was walking away, when you mentioned that Colorado sponsor, I thought you said Meg Toilet.
Oh.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's about right with her.
I know. Yeah, Meg Froelich. I don't know.
Froelich. It sounds like toilet.
I don't know how to pronounce it, honestly. F-R-O-E.
I'm not making fun of you. I think it describes her pretty well.
Yeah. Everything that she came out of her mouth was evil.
Well, that's Colorado now, unfortunately. It's fallen.
Yeah, so. What a shame. First they went for pot. And the libertarians and the people who aren't that bad against pot are like, so what? But it's, I don't know, like, what else is coming with it?
Slippery slope.
I don't know. I think they've been sliding it down a long time. I'm not actually blaming the pot. I'm being a little bit facetious, but still, it doesn't come with the positive changes. That's for sure.
Yeah. Well, I was wondering, you said that you don't like TPUSA, or you just don't trust them?
Oh. I definitely don't really... I don't know what I would trust them with, but I don't really pay attention to the stuff that they say. They used to make cool memes. And I used to kind of like Charlie Kirk, but he's just kind of smart with the Groypers, who were just honest Catholics expressing their concerns about him propping up and promoting radical homosexuals as, like, leaders, so especially that black guy. And he got kind of smart and snarky with them. And he seemed kind of, I don't know, like, phony. And so...
You mean a poser?
Yeah. Yeah, a poser. Yeah, so I don't...
That's what I'd say. He's a poser.
Right. So I don't think that they seem like a bunch of rhinos. Put it that way.
Yeah. With Candace Owens and a bunch, she basically pops out a baby, throws it at her husband, and she's on there the next two weeks.
Yeah, that's not good. What the heck? I don't know if she's still with them, but she's...
Oh, no, she still is.
She's definitely into the woman thing.
Oh, yeah.
on an ego kick, which is not good.
Boy, did you, you know Discord, right?
I've heard of it. Yes, I've used it a little bit. JLP has a Discord.
Do you know that they become arbiters of the truth on March 28th?
I've known that they've been liberals for a long time,
they're banning for disinformation, misinformation. Now it's part of their TOS, their terms of service.
Wow.
March 28th is when, and I guess they want to lose all that sweet, sweet nitro money from all those conservative Discord servers that they have, you know, that subscribe to it. I thought they'd never go that low.
I thought that they had somebody in on their board or in their decision-making or maybe among their staff, Discord, as Unicorn. They share, somehow affiliated with Unicorn Riot.
I saw an Indeed Discord job application.
Uh-huh.
And you should see they have 48 different genders.
Wait, what? You said job application for Discord?
Yeah.
And they have 48 genders?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they're just a bunch of psychos, liberals.
And they also think that being a non-straight is a protected class, and you actually have more rights than straight people.
Right. Yeah. No, I heard. Do you know what Unicorn Riot is? That's the Antifa-affiliated, supposedly, they're a propaganda machine, basically. They're a media outlet, but they're Antifa.
Just a bunch of soys. And they don't really scare me. The only time the Portland ones worry me, and the ones in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, worry me. But the rest of them really don't, you know, unless they're really, really organized with money. You know that's the only time they're scary. Most of the time they just are a bunch of individuals who get together and play dress up, you know.
Well, you can say that, but the media is on their side, you know.
Oh, that's what I'm trying to say.
Discord is on their side.
The big ones that are actually have money are the scary ones. Scary, you know, division ones. I'm talking about this, your typical, you know, I'm going to complain about the Civil War site in North Carolina. Yeah. And I'm just thinking, oh, shut up, soy boy.
Okay. Nice.
But anyhow, I'm glad I'm happy that, you know, that the TPUSA, I mean, I like them. If they were worth anything, honestly, Hake, they would actually help, you know, people, real true conservatives, get elected. They'd use the students that they hire to promote, you know, people, you know, that are true conservatives and get them up and get them in office.
Yeah.
That's what I say. Yeah.
Yeah,
and
but
that's why I say they talk. Instead of talking, why don't you actually do some action? You know that?
You know what? That's what I saw at AFPAC, is they're supporting people, and they want to support people who are actually for America and not wolves in sheep's clothing or phonies.
AFPAC is the true CPAC, right? That's what CPAC is.
Yeah, America First. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's where JLP spoke.
I went to CPAC back in 2004 in D.C. when I was working in a nonprofit role in Alexandria. And it was, I got to see Dick Cheney, everybody speak, you know, Bush Jr., you know, it was pretty cool.
Wow.
I mean, even though I know they're both neocons, but
right.
Still was pretty cool. You know,
interesting.
To see them.
Yeah, JLP spoke at CPAC in like 2007 and maybe another time too. I'm pretty sure he spoke twice.
Why isn't he invited? Has he tried to ask him to see if he can get on board again? Or
I don't know.
He's not interested.
But I think that they play it very safe now.
Yeah, they do.
Yep. So they've kind of gone soft. I've heard that. I think I might have heard it on Anchor Baby's new show, that's Nick the Anchor Baby, I don't know if he said it on his show, but every so-called conservative organization drifts left, meaning towards evil. Yeah.
Yeah,
I think he did say it on his show.
They think they need to do that to survive, but they really don't.
Yep. Anyway, appreciate it, Richard. Nice to hear from you.
Take care, Hake.
All right, you as well.
Just be careful on Discord. I hope Jussie's server can survive.
Don't say stuff like that. Thank you, Richard. Appreciate it.
All right, take care. Uh-huh.
Bye. It's the Robert Conquest Law of Politics, says Nicolas, the Anchor Baby, host of Anchor Baby's new show. I'm going to get to the rest of the callers, Jeremiah in Louisiana and Rick in Maine and the rest of you. Hang tight, but Nick says the behavior of an organization can best be predicted by assuming that it to be controlled by a secret cabal of its enemies. Very interesting. Very interesting. I'm going to get to this kissing up to black females thing and kissing up to the homosexuals and all that stuff and feminism by way of this movie that's out called The Power of the Dog or something like that. I don't mean to promote it, but I'm inadvertently promoting it by talking about it. Whatever. And your calls. But first, how about some more Huntingtons, guys? You guys like the Huntingtons? You guys liked them yesterday when I played that song called Tell Me Goodnight. It was not a good message. Like, don't be acting like that, guys. But, all desperate. But, oh, this is a fast song. It's only about 90 seconds long, so you don't have to cover your ears very long. Or you can just grin and bear it, you musical Philistines. This is from the 2000 album called Plastic Surgery, out on Tooth and Nail Records. Huntington's Moral Threat. Enjoy, and I'll be back for hour two. Hang tight. Well, wasn't that nice? Guantanamo Bay music, says Tom New. He is comparing it to torture. No, please, Hake, grin and bear it. Hake music, good for waterboarding. Yes, we love your music, Hake, says Kevin Howe. Huntington's Catherine Payne likes it. Thumbs up. Thank you. At least somebody around here knows music. No-name bands. Best part about being behind is fast forwarding through the music, says Ian Hogg. Terrible. By the way, Robbie over there on Facebook says, about Mike, my caller Mike from Michigan from yesterday, referencing that town as being a white version of a violent ghetto, said it was inaccurate. Rogers, Arkansas is a beautiful town in the Ozarks. What? So, and I let it slide, too. I should never let it slide when a black tries to cite their lies as fact. Terrible. 90-pound wuss or bust, says Bill West. This is a reference to that Christian band, 90-pound wuss. They were contemporaries of Huntington's, alongside Goaty Hook and all them. Tooth and Nail bands, right? I liked them when in the mid to late 90s or early 2000s. I really liked that stuff. And so that's why I play it, to share it with you. Well, thank you for sharing this time with me, guys. Okay. Let me get to another call before I get into this story about the power of dogs. Somebody said that it's basically another Brokeback Mountain. Promotes the alphabet, says Tim Scott. Yeah, You don't have to see the movie to know the purpose of the propaganda, says Vladimir Vendeyas. Yeah, true. But let me get to ERICK in Selma, Alabama. ERICK, E-R-I-C-K, in Selma, Alabama. How you doing, man?
All is well, James Hake. It is he that talketh with thee. I am here, still here. All is well. Just calling in and shout you out. Now, I want to respond to, yeah, I was talking about Charlie Kirk, and I honestly used to like the guy. I still love him or whatever, but now I see he's not like a true conservative Christian like he tried to put on. He panders to the gays.
Yeah.
He want to pander to the blacks and all this fake social injustice stuff. Even Candace Owens, she's not a true. I used to love her. I mean, I still love her, but she's not a true conservative Christian woman. If she was, she would have honored her black father and married a black man.
Oh, yeah, huh?
Soon as she had the baby, she was right back to work. JLP said that, right back to work. She got her own little Candace show. It's a great show or whatever, but she's not staying home with their child.
Yeah, and isn't that show on Daily Wire, Ben Shapiro's thing?
Man, yeah,
Ben Shapiro should know better.
Conservative too. Ben Shapiro is fake now too. He don't believe in Jesus. I just
that's true.
Seen like videos of that. He don't believe in Jesus. True. I know Jesus is real because I have seen him through revelation. That's how I know he real. This ain't for nobody else. I've seen Jesus through revelation, so that's how I know he's real.
Okay, yeah, that is true. He doesn't. Yeah, and then, yeah, what a mess. Not good. Yeah, she got with a British guy and genocided his babies. Well, not genocided, but she made mixed babies with him. That's true.
Yeah, man, mixed babies, man. It's wrong. I mean, you have a black father. She's not honoring her parents.
Right.
Her parents are black. I mean, you mixing stuff up. It's not supposed to be that way. You're supposed to honor your father. You know, and
yeah.
I have to find me a beautiful black woman to marry because I'm honoring my mother because I forgave them. Forgave my
nice. Parents. Yeah, I think that there's something to that, honestly.
Yeah, she hates her parents. That's
yeah.
She hates her black father. You know, that's
right.
Why she's trying to be like so, like, think she's a conservative. So she got all the conservative talking points, but on the inside, she's liberal.
Her tweets are all right. And then, but then you look at her, and listen to her, if you can bear listening. I don't know if that's my anti-woman side coming out, but it's kind of obnoxious to hear her. I just kind of walk out of the room. If I happen to be in a room with Fox News playing, and she starts talking, it's like, oh, gosh. Let me get out to where something's not grating my ears. I'd rather listen to Hake's music.
Yeah, She only got the conservative talking points and the other females like AOC plus three. She's
right.
Beautiful. Candace is beautiful. They're beautiful women, but they're radical.
Yeah, only on the outside.
Only on the outside,
yep.
Man. Like, that's why us men, we have to protect these women from themselves. They can't help themselves, man. Us men, we have to stand up and love these women the right way and get the love from God and then give it to the women. Us men, we ain't got no love to give to women. We got to go to God and then give it to them.
Yeah.
So we got to love the women and protect them from themselves. Can't listen to women. If a man gets it wrong, we got to let the women got to let the man get it right. You can't make him get it right. You can't beat him down to anything because, man, he going to get it right eventually.
I really liked Jesse Lee Peterson's biblical question last week. He answered it in church about what women want and what men want. And it was not what I was expecting. I was expecting that I had the right answer. That is, we all just want an ego boost. But then again, I said in the expert segment on the Jason Lee Peterson show that do we really know what we want? That's not what's right. That ego boost, propping up the ego, using one another to worship and be worshipped by one another is just all evil, all ego and Satan. And that's what... Like JLP says, the women are looking for a father's love, but instead they get screwed, which is not good. Sorry, yeah, kids and
right.
adults,
yeah.
But
we got to do these.
I don't know how else to say
right.
it. Yeah,
do women right.
Do right
man.
By them.
Got to
yep.
love them
mm-hmm.
because they're gonna be wrong anyway. We have to like correct them and protect
yeah.
them from themselves.
Patience.
You know, that's what I'm starting to do now. I'm not like calling women the B words, and I'm trying to stop all of that because I know they don't know no better.
Yeah.
But still love them if they're wrong.
Yeah.
Got to love our women out here, all the women.
There's a time and place for the B word, but you're right. A lot of the blacks have gotten out of control with that.
Yeah. Yep. Lastly, I want to respond to what you just said. It is a time and a place that is so true because it's a difference between a woman and a B word. A woman stays in a woman's place, and a B word is a female dog. You understand me?
Yep.
That's exactly what it is.
So to quote NWA. No, never mind. I won't say it.
Never mind. All right, though, bro. I just want to get it off my chest on a Tuesday. You hear me?
Nice.
Today is my off day, so I just wanted to call in.
I appreciate it.
Got to go back to work tomorrow. So shout out to Hake the Great One. Amazing show. And I got some of my friends subscribing to your show now. They've been asking me about it because I've been sending them screenshots. They've been seeing me in the chat. So
right,
we got
on.
Some more fans coming, man. We got to make James Hake famous. You need to be on a level with Trump. Because your message is way more powerful than his.
Oh, wow. Well, I appreciate that, man.
Behold, a greater than President Trump is here. And it's James Hake. But that's all I wanted to say. All right, bro.
All right. Thank you, Eric. You too.
Take care.
Bye. That's Eric, a.k.a., can I say it? King Drop in the chat, in the YouTube chat. Jib Jab says, if James didn't love women, would he always not be saying how pretty they are on his show, even the ugly ones? Anyway, thank you, guys. That was fun. Before I get to Rick and Maine, hang tight, man. Hang tight. Let me briefly cover at least part one of this, the power of dog thing. So I mentioned this in Hake News at the end of hour two, I think, of the J.S. Lee Peterson Show, yes, indeed. And this is a quote shared by Commie Nonsense Network, CNN. This is a quote, and listen, their accomplishments are titanic and inspiring. Serena and Venus, I apologize and completely celebrate you. Barf! Am I right? That's a female movie director, a quote from a female movie director called Jane Campion. Do I have a picture of her from being old? I think I do have I might have a screenshot of her from like a headline on this story, Power of Dog, something, something. Oh yeah, there she is. Director Jane Campion. And look, she's wearing these black rimmed glasses in front of and she has this white hair. This is the CNN headline, director Jane Campion, it's spelled like champion, but no H, Campion, I presume that's how you pronounce it, apologizes for thoughtless, her word, comment about Venus and Serena Williams. And what is she talking about? Like, I saw this quote, I'm like, what? And director of what? And so I found out that it's a movie director, and yes, a woman. And what a shame, she's looking kind of like a witch or a hag or something. Sorry, ladies, if you look anything like this, don't take it personally. And Jane Campion herself, don't take it personally if you're catching the Hake Report, Jane Campion. But she was apologizing to tennis stars Venus and Serena Williams, those two black girls, young women. They're about my age, I want to say, maybe a little bit younger. They've been tennis stars. Venus was the one who came on the scene first when I was in like high school, I want to say, senior year of high school. No, they're not brothers. No, they are real black ladies or females. Anyway, she made a comment during her acceptance speech on Sunday night's Critics' Choice Awards. Whatever that is, these people just sit around and give each other awards. The Power of the Dog apparently is a movie. Apparently it's a Western. I'll get into that. It's a fake Western. She's a movie director. She received backlash after she acknowledged other Best Director nominees whom she beat out, and they were all men. So the woman beat out the men in Women's History Month. Shout out to Lisa over there in the Facebook chat. Okay, Hake, whatever would you do if you had a daughter one day? Laughing. She'd be thinking like a man. Hopefully. I don't know. We'll see. This is what she said when she was acknowledging other Best Director nominees who were all men. And she said, and I don't see what the reference is, but she said, Venus and Serena, you're such marvels. However, you don't play against the guys like I have to. That's right, because it's women's tennis. They're the best, supposedly, or at least Serena is, at women's tennis. And this woman is purportedly the best for this one movie, maybe. Which, affirmative action, probably. The gay agenda, probably. Somebody said, compared this movie to Brokeback Mountain, which is a gay movie. Radical homosexual. So I don't see what these tennis ladies had to do with her movie. Weird, huh? CNN's Sandra Gonzalez writes, in addition to being inaccurate that Venus and Serena don't face the men, the tennis champions have faced off against men, and I add, and lost, has it not been true that the top women's tennis player is not as good as the top 200th tennis male tennis player? Women's tennis, not as good as men's tennis. And by the way, I heard from one of you guys, I think, that like a high school team beat out some national women's soccer team. You know, football, communist football, not to be confused with American football. So the women are not as good as the men. This woman faced off against men for a movie, because it's not women's movies and men's movies, although maybe there is. And she won. So she gets to be like that. Anyway, some viewed the Williams sisters famously went up against a German tennis player ranked 203. And he won? The guy was smoking during breaks and he won. Those Germans. Nice. Reminds me of some of these old school males athletes from back in the day. Anyway, this Campion woman, Jane Campion, whom I so cruelly called a hag or a witch, her statement was viewed as dismissive of the two successful black females' accomplishments. Oh, gosh. And they capitalized black, the B in the word black. Give me a break. So I guess the context was Campion was acknowledging the many incredible women present in the audience, including the Williams sisters. What an honor to be in the room with you, she said at the time that she made that backhanded comment about facing off against men, specifically addressing the pair before asking them for tennis lessons. An under 15 boys soccer team? The full-grown women's soccer team lost against an under 15 boys soccer team. Whoa. So that's like, who's that 14-year-old so-called boy who's that? Not to be mean, but that's like Emmett Till and playing against the women's soccer. Anyway. Interesting point, huh? Emmett Till was 14 when he died, but he allegedly whistled and allegedly grabbed, but maybe he didn't, that 21-year-old young woman who was a wife to one of the guys who allegedly killed him. Don't know. But, you know, it just gives you context that men under 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, Tamir Rice, 12, they thought he was 21, he was big. And he could easily beat a woman. FYI, just a side note. Not that it has anything to do with anything. So this woman's being all pro-woman, and she's being all, oh gosh, when a woman wins an award, she wants to group all the women together and say, let me acknowledge all the incredible women present in the audience. What an ego, huh? The woman's ego, out of control. Or am I wrong? Am I wrong? Anyway, this, I'll talk about her movie later. I'll talk about her movie later, but she apologized to Venus and Serena Williams because she said, what did she say again? You're such marvels. However, you don't play against the guys like I have to. It is accurate. CNN's Sandra Gonzalez, the writer of that article, Propaganda, said, in addition to being inaccurate, the tennis champions have faced off against men, but they haven't. Have they won? No. This woman won against the men in a movie. In a, you know, movie awards, critics' choice, critics are not objective. Sports, pretty objective, right? Your skills against their skills, your skills win out. Unless there's a crooked ref or somebody throws the game, right? Right. Anyway, I'll talk more about this, but I got to get to some more calls. There's one line open, guys. Rick in Maine, thank you for holding, sir. How are you doing?
Not bad, James. How are you?
Doing fine, thank you.
I got a few questions here for you about... is it not in the Ten Commandments, one of the commandments states, thou shalt not kill?
Yeah. What part of thou shalt not kill don't you understand? And that's a reference to murder, obviously, because God clearly did command people to kill and even death penalty.
Do we have laws in this country against murder?
Yeah, we do.
Okay. So how can any legitimate state or country make it legal for any woman to murder a child?
Yeah.
So where we're going with this LGBTQ mess, which I think they're all insane anyway.
They're not the only ones, but you're right.
They are committing first degree murder. There's no debate about it.
Because it's premeditated?
Because it's premeditated.
Yeah.
Someone who kills somebody by accident, say in a car accident or anything like that, that's to be expected. But when you premeditate to kill someone, inclusive of a child, because my half-brother was murdered.
Yeah. I think you told me about that one
remember
time.
Remember that?
I vaguely remember. Yeah. Go ahead.
You remember the sentence I told you that was handed down from that court?
No, I don't remember.
The guy got 7 years. His accomplice got one.
Wow. 7 years for
murder. We're not, premeditated murder. And not only because of that, James, they committed the crime, and then they dismembered the evidence and spread it over 5 counties in south central Georgia.
Meaning the body. They did that to the body?
Precisely.
Wow.
That's destruction of evidence.
Yep.
So, that in play, when someone has an abortion, what do they do to the child?
That's premeditated with malice aforethought.
Premeditated.
Yeah,
it is also dismemberment of a human fetus.
Yeah, true. Not good.
So why aren't we prosecuting every single one of these people that have killed, premeditated, their child?
Well, I'll tell you, they're not getting away with it. They're guilt-ridden, these people are. They're judging themselves, judging others. They're some of the most judgmental people.
Yes,
Full of regret and covering it over with shamelessness and
demon
celebrate,
rat.
Shout my abortion type stuff. Demon rats. Yes, indeed.
Demon rats.
Yeah, I know some ladies who've had abortions over the years, and some of them are just guilty and broken up about it. Many of them don't get past it, but you can get past it because you just acknowledge it's wrong. It's people do wrong, and there's such lies and such cultural acceptance of this.
Yeah.
You can't treat it the same as your average murder, because you have you have half of society accepting it as fine, and so you have to change the hearts of the people, tell the truth, and
you know,
don't back down.
You're right there as far as that goes.
Yeah.
But when they do that, James, they are just as guilty as the individual that is committing the crime.
Yeah.
It's called conscience. If you don't have conscience about your child and you murder it, there's something to be said about that. Society is teaching these young women completely wrong.
Right.
They're following Satan and doing his bidding. So wake up, people.
Yep. There are people. There are people who are so blind. That they think that their lives are better for it, and they promote it like crazy. But they have no actual peace. They're not. Those are not kind women. They are misguided.
No, they're not.
Yeah.
That's why I said.
Yeah.
Follow your demon.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. I wanted to get that off my chest, James, and hopefully it sheds a little light to maybe one person.
Yeah, perhaps.
Have a good
so.
One, buddy.
You too, Rick. Appreciate you.
Take All right, care. Man.
All right. One line open, guys. Jib Jab says, I knew a woman who had an abortion when she was young, and now she's in her 50s and regrets it so much still. Wow. Angela says, I knew so many who had multiple abortions. It's sad. Or no, so many who've had multiple abortions. Lisa J is over there on Facebook is the one whose comment I read. But I bet there's a bunch of women who think that their lives are way better because of it. Hmm. Yeah, true. Yeah, a lot of people think that. And you hear that woman from, what's that great band? Fleetwood Mac. With that one singer, there's multiple different singers on that band. Great band, but awful person. And she was like, oh, I wouldn't have had my career had it not been for abortion. Wow. Would you give up Stevie Nicks' beautiful voice on those beautiful Fleetwood Mac songs to save that child? Or are you selfish? terrible. B. Livingston says, I would not date Hake at all. Good, I wasn't asking. Anyway, what a mess, huh? Terrible mess. Let me briefly get to Jeremiah in Louisiana. I don't know what he wants to talk about, but Jeremiah, you're calling back. You disconnected there for a few minutes. How are you doing? I can barely hear you. Are you there?
I shall rejoice. I'll be glad.
It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Shouldn't have left you. Anyway.
Hey, you're funny, man. You know that?
Thank
Real
you.
Real funny. Entertaining.
You laughing I'm, with me or at me?
At you.
Aww.
I haven't been able to check out your show lately. Been kind of busy.
I understand.
But
we are
course.
Working men.
Yeah. Of course, though, you would be up to your regular antics.
Oh, you know me.
How's the kingdom, man? How's it going?
Going well, thank you. Appreciate it. Nice to hear
from
you.
I feel gas prices ain't good, though. That ain't going on.
Yeah.
How does the kingdom look like? It's going down right now. You know what I'm saying?
I'm glad that I moved into L.A. close to work, so it doesn't affect me as much, but that's not good for the country, for sure.
No, it's not at all.
It's affecting that's everything. Not. Yeah.
It's like $6 out there, ain't it? Gas.
Getting there, yeah.
Yeah, I know food is crazy right now.
Yep.
Some truckers ain't trucking right now. It ain't going like it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Infrastructure just not how it's supposed to be.
I think it started with the China virus communist shutdowns.
Yeah.
And the restrictions. Yep. So
I like that. I heard one dude talking about, it might have been a female talking about them, those labs, those Ukrainian labs they got. That was kind of interesting.
Yeah, I don't know anything about that.
Deontay
on my show on Friday at the end of the show, I think, he mentioned that. And I haven't looked into it at all, but Tucker Carlson over there on Fox News, one of the honest journalists, he mentioned it. And I think the State Department or some department said, oh, we don't have that. And then I think that there may be some truth to it. I have no idea. I haven't looked into it at all. But it is interesting.
Right. So, I guess what I want to talk about today, and there's so much I can talk about. We, you know how we get down.
Yeah.
But I don't know if you can look it up for me right now. I'm driving, so I'm not sure if I can look it up.
That's okay. Isaiah, you don't have to look it up.
Isaiah chapter 3, verse 12, I think.
Uh-huh.
Talking about the daughters of Zion, right?
Okay.
Now, reading that verse, who would you think those people are talking about today?
Can you paraphrase what the gist of the message is?
He's talking about the daughters of Zion having a haughty, being haughty and having these outstretched necks, you know, these attitudes, and how it goes on to say, you know, instead of a sweet smell, you'll stink, and instead of beautiful hair, you'll be bald.
Wow.
Who's that talking about, Hank? Who's that talking about?
It sounds like it's... I couldn't tell you who it's talking about.
Well, who does it sound like it's talking about?
Sounds like it's talking about certain women, haughty women.
You know, let's stop the game. Who does it sound like it's talking about?
Bald, outstretched necks?
Yeah, you make it clear a lot. You make it known a lot. Who has the attitude, or who is the ghetto?
Oh, and the bald heads and stuff like that?
Yeah, all that, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So you think that the daughters of Zion, that the black females, the black females?
I want to know your word.
You think
I know what I think. It ain't even about what I think anymore. It's what I know. I want your opinion on that. What do you think it's talking about?
I think it's talking about the daughters of Israel.
So does that sound like though?
You keep on beeping. It sounds like you have the phone against your face, and you keep on pressing buttons.
No, it's just my phone's kind of sensitive. It's raining outside, so it might be a little wet. But who does that sound like, Hank?
I don't know, man. It sounds like you think
that you're beating around the bush.
Because I...
No, are you scared to say it?
I'm not scared. I'm not scared, man.
So why do you make fun of black people and their attitudes, or how they? I see all the time in your chat.
Right.
Your little minions talk about, I can smell this one from a mile away. Like we stink. And I get it. I understand the attitude. The attitude is a lot. Like
right.
You can smell. I tell women that all the time. I can smell your attitude.
Uh-huh.
Stink.
Right.
Especially, well, my women, because I don't care if I drill women. But
nice.
My women, you know what I'm saying? You know, your attitude stinks. So... Not just that, but
do you think that
being bald and all that?
But he's saying the Lord will make your foreheads bare. I don't know if it means entirely bald, but yeah, a lot of women are going kind of bald. Not good.
Yeah, but the outstretched necks and the haughty attitude, like, who's it talking about? Right?
Women. Specifically women? The daughters of Zion.
It's definitely not talking about white women, is it?
Oh yeah, those white women. There's some. You ever seen G.I. Jane? You ever
Come
seen?
On.
You ever Let's seen the real. Movie G.I. Jane? She had a bald head.
Let's be real, Hank.
That is real.
Let's be real, Hank. You don't. You're not going to talk down about your white women.
Oh yeah, I do.
You're not going to say they stink.
You haven't been listening to the show.
They have a haughty attitude, or they have outstretched neck.
I definitely just did.
You're not going to do that.
I just spent the whole show doing that. You missed it.
You do that to black women.
Uh-uh.
You do that a lot. 90% of your show is talking about black women and how they stink and how they have this attitude.
You don't know proportions.
The stinky attitude. Yeah, I do.
You do not know proportions.
Yeah, I do.
That's a bad estimate.
That's a very accurate estimate, as a matter of fact.
All right,
it might be a little bit lower. I might have a little bit lower. I might actually give you a little bit of credit.
Yeah, thank you. So that's Jeremiah from Louisiana bringing another verse, another Bible passage that in his mind proves that the blacks are the true Israelites, I think.
That's just one out of many, but
right.
I wanted to know, I see you're scared to actually admit who it sounds like. You don't even want to know. You don't
but
even
I don't
want
know who is acting,
like.
The Jewish women act like that.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Really, Hank?
Yes.
Really?
Indeed. You ever heard of, what's that woman, Spector, Barbara Spector? So, she has a haughty spirit, or did have a haughty, is she still alive? She's all, we will be resented for our leading role in bringing the diversity against the white countries. Something like
so
that.
So you're going to twist it up to make it seem like they're bald and they got this stinky attitude.
So, yeah, right? they got this horrific attitudes.
And all that. It says a lot more than that in that little bit right there.
What's
talking about what they wear, bonnets, and all this jewelry.
Every woman in history has worn bonnets.
And they don't have all this jewelry either.
Every race of women has worn bonnets, to my knowledge.
Yes. They don't wear all these all these ornaments on their ankles and on their on their nose and the ears. They don't do all of that, Hank. You know who that is, Hank. You do. I know you do.
This is so funny because it's not a, it doesn't speak well of these women, but you want to claim them as your own.
It's a curse. But no, it's a curse. What it's giving you is it's identifying who the daughters of Zion are. It's not just the daughters of Zion. It actually tells you who the men are. It's telling you about the men as well. The men being killed, being slain. Yeah, it talks about that as well.
So
yeah.
You say so you
not,
know
it's not just about the women, but it talks about the daughters of Zion. That's why it's so important.
So you're saying that you know proportions, right? You
can, I'm saying that I know I'm smart enough to know to identify these people. It's not about you're saying that there since all these bad things are happening. I can care less about the bad things. It's about who is talking about the daughters
human
of Zion
beings
and how you can identify those people.
Human beings, Jeremiah. But I was saying you can estimate what percentage of my show is talking about blacks. You estimated a little bit less than 90%. To give me credit. But can you even per capita, bro? I couldn't even pronounce it correctly. Azvador with a super chat on Odyssey says, Jeremiah can't even per capita. Do you even per... I keep on saying per capita. Do you even per capita, bro? Do you know what I'm talking about?
Do I even per capita, bro?
Do you per capita?
Y'all, you know what? It's like, okay, we get you in one part, and then y'all go to y'all make up a whole different another stat.
Yeah, I know.
It's like, it's another gentleman or somebody said, the lies are always distorted. The truth, now the truth is under all those lies. You just got to dig out. You got to dig those lies out to get to the truth. But the truth, it never goes anywhere. It's not gonna break. It's not gonna bend. You can't destroy it. But those lies that y'all tell, that y'all pile on top of each other, that's what gets destroyed.
So is that a no?
Per capita, that's another lie.
No, it's not.
I have a lot of those lies. The media is lies. Y'all full lies.
You're so he's a per capita denier.
Lie, Hank. And you laugh. You have that little goofy, corny laugh.
Right.
That just lets me know that you're a part of it.
You're a per capita denier is what you're telling me.
A per capita denier? Your stats I don't care about your stats because
right.
I've lived.
I know. We've all lived through your attitude.
You can't tell me about what I've lived through.
Yes,
with
I can.
Stats. I could care less about your stats if I've lived through something.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So
but I know that you have the same attitude as the black females who you say are out of control.
You can try that, Tank. I know that's your go-to.
What?
It doesn't work.
You do have the attitude.
It doesn't work. Your stats is female. That's what's female.
Stay in denial, buddy.
You have stats. I have stats. We can both do the stat thing. That's nothing.
I know, but you don't understand per capita.
I can tell you the experience that I've lived through.
Fine.
That's a man.
Very cute.
That's what a man is going to do.
Yeah.
A man,
and I can tell you my experiences, too.
A man's going to get up and still do what he has to do to take care of his business, to take care of his family. A man's going to stand on principle.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
A leader, a man's going to help his community. A man's going to help.
Keep telling us what a man is, poser.
A man is a man of principle, a man that fears God, a man that is going to do the duties of God, which is keep the law, statutes, and commandments. You don't do that. Y'all don't do that.
Okay.
Yeah. Y'all Christians, y'all modern-day Christians that is walking through the earth right now, your tongue's walking through the earth, y'all don't understand what a real Christian is because y'all don't have the law.
Okay.
and y'all never will go by it. Y'all
right.
will never. It never will happen. That's why all this stuff in the world happens.
Are you sitting at the Popeyes drive-thru right now? Are you at the Popeyes drive-thru right now?
Am I what?
At the Popeyes drive-thru.
No, I'm actually off. I just got off of work, and I'm
right
on my way home with my family.
Well,
but,
right on.
Yeah, like I was saying.
Yes.
Y'all, you can make all the jokes about Popeyes and all that. What's serious is y'all will never have the law. And that's why y'all perishing. That's why your kingdom is crumbling.
Well,
right
thank
now.
You for letting
that's
us know.
Russia and China
Very
is
edifying.
About to get Russia and China. Hey, and just to let you know, Russia and China, right? They're gonna get together. They might get in bed together. But that's not even that's being very big. That's not even the kicker. Are you familiar with the Valley of Jehoshaphat?
You know what? I can't get into that today. You can call me another day on that. Your girlfriend has a super chat for me. Your girlfriend has a super chat for you, too.
Super chat, but you can't get it to it. All right.
Right. The way Jeremiah screams at you made it easy to figure out he had a...
Am I screaming?
He had a baby mama. 100%.
Am I screaming?
The way you were. The way you...
No.
The way Jeremiah screams at you made it...
I'm loud. I'm sorry.
Made it easy...
Tell her I'm country. I'm loud. So that's just how it is.
But you're Louisiana country. That's with an asterisk. You're not the polite type of country. You're a Louisiana country. I hear that Louisiana blacks have an attitude. The way Jeremiah screams at you, will you let me read the super chat without interruption? Your girlfriend
read
states,
the
way Jeremiah screams at you made it easy to
Why
figure out.
Mad?
I'm putting him on hold because he can't stay quiet for a whole super chat. The way Jeremiah screams at you made it easy to figure out he had a baby mama, 100%. Jeremiah, I will let you respond to that. I don't know if that's true or not. You don't even have to acknowledge it, because...
I didn't even know I was screaming. I know it's raining outside.
It's more
I'm
important
driving,
that he was screaming
so
than he has
a
baby mama. Do you have a baby mama? You don't have to answer it.
I have wives.
Oh,
I have.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Take care.
Do you have a wife, Hank?
Not at this time. Gotta go. Thank you, sir. Take care. Asmador with the super chat says his family... His family. Well, thank you, guys. I appreciate it. Thank you for bearing with me through that long call. Man. Let me talk about this thing going on, this last bit of about the power of dog before I get back to calls. Hang tight, callers. Hang tight. Luke in Indiana coming to you next. Bobby in Texas afterwards. And the rest of the callers, I shall see. Benedict Cumberbatch versus Sam Elliott. You guys heard these names before? So I was telling you, just when I was telling you about this story about this woman kissing up to the black female tennis players, this woman, female movie director, Jane Campion. By the way, I have an older picture of Jane Campion. She used to be kind of pretty. You know, she's still kind of pretty for a witch hag, you know, with her white hair and her feminist mindset and kissing up to the black women. That's not attractive, but look at her. Wow. That's her in 1990, just 22 years ago. And now she has this white hair and wide-rimmed glasses, black-rimmed glasses. Look at this beautiful, curly... dirty brown hair, light brown hair, somewhat of a tortured smile, but it's still a smile, kind of attractive. And then, now, show the other picture of her. She's all old and white. Okay, everybody gets old, it's not good, but look at that. Yikes. Yikes. At least she's not too fat, though. That's nice. But anyway, this woman made a Western. Oh, please. She made this, apparently, right? Because I haven't seen it, nor do I intend to. But she made this dumb wannabe Western movie, allegedly, right? With all kinds of allusions to homosexuality, according to one based guy. As any actor based, but he was a Western actor. And I'll get to him. Sam Elliott. You guys know who that is? And this wannabe Western movie called The Power of the Dog is starring this purported male feminist, Benedict Cumberbatch, who did an okay job as Sherlock Holmes in this TV series, but And he's also in those Marvel movies. Oh, gosh. I think he plays, like, Mr. Mystery or Dr. Mystery or Dr. Strange or something like that. You guys know. If you know, whatever. And it also stars that old Spider-Man girlfriend, Mary Jane actress, Kirsten Dunst. She was in that Spider-Man, the older Spider-Man movies, the one that came out around 9/11, 2001, right around then. Benedict Cumberbatch is all grandstanding because this Sam Elliott guy poo-pooed this Western, this so-called Western. And this Benedict Cumberbatch, I'm talking about two actors. Sam Elliott, I think he's 77 years old. How old is Benedict Cumberbatch, who's probably not American, by the way, 45 years old? Yeah, and he was born in London. Get him out of here, foreigner. Right? But, okay, so this is according to CNN Commie Nonsense Network. Without directly addressing comments made last week by actor Sam Elliott, who poo-pooed this movie as having allusions to homosexuality, I'll read the quote. It's pretty funny. Or pretty good. Cumberbatch, this Benedict Cumberbatch, 45-year-old male feminist, apparently, or he's pretending to be one, right? Just to stay in the acting game. I'm going to tell myself that that's what he's doing. But it's still shameful. It's wrong. Cumberbatch explained in a panel this weekend that, okay, Sam Elliott was on a podcast. He criticized Netflix, the CEO and the CEO's wife, one of the CEOs, donated to the Black Lives Matter candidate for district attorney here in LA. Evil. So he's basically like George Soros type, you know? And the female too, the wife too. Shameful. So Netflix had this movie, Power of the Dog. And Sam Elliott, this old school actor, 77 years old. He starred in a lot of, I don't know how old school he is, but he starred in a lot of Westerns over the decades, since the 60s, I think. And he looks cool, by the way. He was on a podcast criticizing it for its allusions to homosexuality. Allusions of homosexuality, right? Allusion, not illusion, not a mirage, but a reference, right? Cumberbatch explained on a panel this weekend his portrayal of closeted rancher. What? Oh my gosh, you guys are right. Closeted is a buzzword for radical homosexual, but in the closet, right? Or not radical homosexual, but in the closet, hiding the shame, right? Phil Burbank has the power beyond the screen. And this guy says Benedict Cumberbatch, this foreigner, Brit, 45 years old, male feminist, I think if we're to teach our sons to be feminists, what? If we're to teach equality, if we're to understand what poisons the well in men, what creates toxic masculinity, what? We need to understand and look at under the hood of characters like Phil Burbank and see what their struggle is and why that's there in the first place, because otherwise it will just keep repeating itself. In other words, this guy wants gays to be out and shameless, promoting wrong is right, and for men to not be men, and women to be running the show. What a kiss-up. He said that in a conversation with Mariah Kederbai, head of programs at BAFTA. BAFTA is some movie thing, I think. Cumberbatch's response was to a question about why he thought the period film, this so-called Western, made by a woman who kissed up to the Venus and Serena Williams sisters, was an important tale to tell now, and came days after Sam Elliott, a longtime staple of Western films, this Sam Elliott guy. Can you show pictures of this Sam Elliott? I have, like, various pictures of him over the years. And he looks manly, and everyone, here he is at 77 years old, 2018. And I feel like I recognize him. He has this big white-gray mustache over his lips, and he's lean, and he has a full head of white hair, white-gray hair. And he looks like you would enjoy him in a Western movie. I feel like I've seen him in Western movies. I don't watch a lot of movies, but yeah. And then in the older movies, I mean, in the older pictures, there he is, and what, I guess the 70s or something like that? Looking like Burt Reynolds, the bandit, the one and only Burt, kind of. He looks like that. His college picture, he looks like, He looks like Kickflip Chris right here, man. Doesn't he look such a Chad? Look at that guy. That's his college photo in the 1965. Dude. So this guy, for some reason, the dudes age better than the females, right? Maybe because they're not feminists and all haggard and kissing up to all women, right? This guy, that's Sam Elliott, Samuel Elliott, 77 years old now. And so Sam Elliott was a longtime staple in Western films. He said in an interview on WTF with Mark Marone, I feel like that has come up in the news before, this podcast, that the film was not a true Western. All right, so this award-winning kiss-up made by a woman film is not a true Western. Elliot says, you want to talk about that piece of S? That's what all these effing cowboys in that movie looked like. They're all running around in chaps and no shirts. There's all these allusions to homosexuality throughout the blanking movie. That's Sam Elliott talking like a man, talking normal. Elliott received backlash for his comments, but has not responded since the interview. Nice, but hope he doesn't. We'll see. CNN previously reached out to Power of the Dog director Jane Campion, Netflix, and GLAAD, the Gay and Lesbian Alliance Against Defamation, radical homosexual GLAAD, G-L-A-A-D, right, for comment. Benedict Cumberbatch is in this movie, and he's a male feminist, 45 years old. He did not refer to Elliott by name, and he said he had not heard the comments for himself, but he called the remarks very odd. Oh, be quiet. You typical British, phony, intellectual. It's very odd. You're odd. The actors seemed to take issue with the notion that anybody could have anything other than heteronormative. This guy's using heteronormative unironically. Talk about in that blind, brainwashed, lost world of Hollywood, right? This foreign actor. Heteronormative existence because of what they do for a living or where they're born. He says, I think the more we look under the hood of toxic masculinity and try to discover the root causes of it, the bigger we have of dealing with it when it arises in our children, in playgrounds, at school, with their friends, in behavioral patterns we might see in innocent play, and just understand how to police that. What a dumb person, huh? Anyway, Power of the Dog. Dumb movie. Nominated for 12 Oscars this year, including Best Picture, Best Director for Pat Campion, who Elliott also had sharp words for. This Sam Elliott guy, old school guy, he says, she's a brilliant director. Oh, gosh. Come on, don't say that. But anyway, he said that. I love her previous work. This is a 77-year-old man saying it. But what the blank does this woman from down there, New Zealand, oh, she's from New Zealand, know about the American West, he said. And why the blank did she shoot this movie in New Zealand and call it Montana? And say, this is the way it was. That rubbed me the wrong way, pal. That's Sam Elliott. Elliott made his debut, by the way, just for your edification, in 1967's The Way West. Went on to make other westerns such as Butch Cassidy and The Sundance Kid. Breakout role in 85's Mask alongside Cher. Oh, another piece of work. He's starred in more than 30 films, appeared in over 40 television shows, and has lent his voice to countless projects. A king, basically. Anyway, I don't know anything about this Sam Elliott guy other than these comments, but right on to him. Nice. And boo, thumbs down, Benedict Cumberbatch. Let me finally get to Luke in Indiana. It's been on hold forever. What's up, Luke? How are you doing?
How's it going, Hake, my fellow CWP?
Is this Luke or Luca?
Luca.
Oh, it's Luca. Oh, nice to hear from you, man.
Yeah. Isn't it great that COVID is over now?
No, it's not over, and it's not great.
But they got something else to focus on now, including war.
I saw a funny chat in JLP's chat. This person was like, go on with your comment. I'll tell it later. Go ahead.
I was just going to bring it. I heard you talking about chemtrails on the Hake News.
Yeah. I thought of you when I was telling this report. Yeah.
I'm glad you did.
You were right. So silver iodine or something, iodide, and it is indeed toxic, especially at chronic levels and concentrated levels. I don't know how concentrated or chronic it is, but I don't know. And they're seeding the clouds to try to make rain or snow. And people say it's questionable whether it's effective or not, but different areas are doing it to try to combat the drought.
Yeah.
Indeed, weather manipulation is real, I guess. Is it
safe? You made my day.
Is it safe and effective, though? We don't know.
I'm going to have to get a sound bite of you saying you were right. Play that every day.
Right on, man. It's good to hear from you, Luca.
Great show, my friend. Representing 1981.
Nice. Indeed.
Yeah.
We're 40 now. Can you believe it? Take care, man.
I know. Take care.
All right. Bye. Last quick call from Bobby in Texas. Bobby, thank you for holding, man. Go ahead.
Hey, how are you doing, buddy?
Doing well. How are you?
I'm doing well. And just a quick one on that last one. Sam Elliott, man. Well, that dude was a legend when I was a kid.
Nice.
He was in all the good movies. Like the original Quick and the Dead, not the feminist one with Sharon Stone, but like the original.
Okay.
And he was in one recently, too. Like 1889 or something like that, I heard was really good. I haven't seen it, but I've heard good reviews on it.
The Noticer says, Sam Elliott and Clint Eastwood are the only two actors I can tolerate. Nice.
I had the exact same thought when I was thinking about this a minute ago. I was like, those are probably the only two really great of my generation. I mean, John Wayne was good when I was a kid, too, but he was before my time.
Mine, too.
But two that I grew up with were definitely like Good, the Bad, and the Ugly with Clint Eastwood and just a ton of the Sacketts, just tons of stuff with Sam Elliott. He was really good.
Cool. Right on, man.
It was nice to hear from Jeremiah. It's always nice to have a little comic relief on the show.
Yeah, although it's kind of a shame that those Black Hebrew Israelites are in that delusion. Yeah. I guess we all gotta get past our delusions, but it seems like most of us get deeper and deeper into different delusions throughout our life. We get worse over time, not better.
Speaking of comic relief, though, I was sitting there reading my news feed a minute ago, and one popped up, and I just had to call in and bring it to your attention. Jussie Smollett, according to this, he's the star of the Mighty Ducks. Now he's trying to get out of jail with his family playing voicemails from someone saying that if he stayed in jail for the full 5 months, bad things would happen. So his lawyers are trying to like get him out of jail.
Yeah.
So he doesn't have to serve his time like he's supposed to.
Just
so
put him in isolated. Put him in solitary. Yeah. Right?
Yeah. Yeah. Lock him
that's
away
what they're
from
doing
somebody
to,
for a few months.
That's what they're doing to the king, Derek Chauvin. Isn't he in kind of solitary right now for his protection?
I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'm sure. They could put him in the January 6th holding cells. I'm sure those are real great place to live.
Yeah, I hear
I'm sure if those families came through with that kind of, with some anonymous voicemails, I'm sure they would let those guys out.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, what a shame. What a double world we live in where they treat the decent people in jail awful and they treat the evil people and they pamper them. So wrong. That's the female mindset, man. You cater and go soft on the criminals and hard on the innocent and those enforcing the law. Not good.
No. I remember a guy I went to school with, went to jail in, down at Mardi Gras one year. It was about a week after Mardi Gras. And he was in jail with this guy, this rapper, Cash Money, I think was his name. And that dude, he was like running the jail. Like they didn't even lock him in the cell. He was like walking around, doing whatever he wanted, like messing with the guards. Like he had it like celebrities. Just, I guess it's not the same world as the rest of us.
Yeah. Bobby, I got to go. We're over time. It's good to hear from you, man. Take care.
Thank you. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate you. Bye.
All right. Bye. Last quick super chats. Eliel 1478 says, gives a mushroom emoji. Thank you, sir, and I appreciate the support. That's kind. And John WX25 says, nasty lib female / it just wanted to kiss up to the Williams sisters, and it backfired. I know. Poor Jane Campion. Well, thank you, guys. This has been The Hake Report, thehakereport.com. You can catch the Hake News section there, too. I shall hopefully see you tomorrow. Short week this week. Thanks and take care.